Hello everyone, I'm Yashish Jain and my team members are Vivek and Yogesh. We are going to present the topic on Shotkit IO. Our paper title name is Study on Device Design, Working, Performance and Applications of Shotkit IO. This is the outline of the presentation. Let's start with the introduction. Shotkit IO was invented by German scientist Walter S. Schottky. It is a metal to semiconductor junction. Basically, it has two types of junction, Schottky and ohmic junction, based on the doping profile of semiconductor. It is a majority carrier device, unlike to normal PN junction diode. It has some advantages like low forward voltage drop, fast reverse recovery time, and their application is like rectifier, switching device, voltage clamping. It has some limitations like a high reverse leakage current, low breakdown voltage. So for mitigate these limitations, researchers has introduced the most best Schottky device, metal oxide semiconductor. Let's start with the device design part. First in early 1900s, first, a practical device was implemented by touching the metallic whisker to an exposed semiconductor surface. It was used as in wireless detector, and it is cheap, but it is not reliable because the performance of the device would fall away in gradually, and so we have to change the new contact position. We have to find the new contact position. So we move to the next device design, which is simple and which is vacuum deposited metal based Schottky diode, which is simple and fundamental structure. It has some disadvantages like high electric field gradients occur at the metal edge, so which results in limiting the reverse breakdown voltage. So for solving this vacuum deposited metal-based Schottky diode problem, so researchers has come up with an idea of guard ring, where the P+ doped guard ring was inserted, was diffused in N-type epitaxial layer, and so this is solve the problems of electric field gradients. And also this guard ring is overlap of metallization to spread out the field gradients. So this device can be used for a requirement of higher breakdown voltage and high voltage, like in RF-based applications. Okay, now move to the next important device design, which is most best, metal oxide semiconductor, where oxide layer inserted in between metal and metal and semiconductor, which results the reduce of interface state density, which is a non-ideal effect in metal semiconductor diode. And so by reducing interface state density, we observe that we got higher barrier heights and high breakdown voltage and low leakage current. So it is a prominent device which is used in current time. Okay, let's compare with most based structure and the simple metal semiconductor based structure Schottky diode. So in table 1 and table 2 we found that most based device provides a higher barrier heights, and also the ideality factor reaches to the unity, so it is good. But the disadvantages of this most based device is the higher series resistance. So for solving this problem, researchers has found that we can add the interdigit fingers of ohmic and Schottky contacts. And also in table 1 and table 2 we use different oxide layer. Like in table 1 we use zirconium oxide, and table 2 we use tantalum oxides. We found the different numbers in barrier heights and series resistance and ideality factors. So for getting better sensing fields and for enhancing capacitance and higher energy stores, we used different high K dielectric in place of silicon dioxide, and nanostructured graphene is also used for getting high Schottky barrier.
Hello, this is Yogesh Singh. So my part in this term paper is a part of its working properties and its applications. Now when metal and semiconductor are added, then depending upon the relation of metal and semiconductor work function, it can be either Schottky contact or an ohmic contact. Here as a semiconductor we are using N-type. In the first case, when metal work function is greater than the semiconductor work function, we join the metal and semiconductor, there will be band bending, and at junction there is a 5V barrier height. An electron from semiconductor cannot jump this height and have no conduction. Once we apply forward bias, bands will be lifted and the barrier height will be reduced. An electron with higher energy in semiconductor can jump into metal over this reduced barrier height. This process is called thermionic emission, and ISM is the current due to this process only. And IMS current corresponds to the flow of some electron from metal to semiconductor, which is very less comparatively. And in case of reverse bias, bands will come down and electron cannot jump increased barrier, hence ISM is almost equal to zero. Now if semiconductor is heavily doped, then barrier width will be reduced and electron has higher probability for tunneling. We have shown both forward bias and the reverse bias in this case in same plot. Red one is the forward bias and black shows reverse bias. Now in case of the forward bias, barrier height will be reduced. Electron of course can jump over this barrier, but they also tunnel through this reduced barrier width easily. Similarly, in case of the reverse bias, since width is reduced, so electron tunnels from metal to semiconductor, and in both the cases, the current is almost same. This contact is called the near ohmic contact, and IV characteristics will be kind of sublinear as shown. And we saw ISM is due to electron jumping from semiconductor to metal and can be obtained by multiplying the density of charge minus En at the interface for the area A of the junction, and the average of absolute value of x component of thermal velocity of electrons Vth x bar. Then using Maxwell-Boltzmann velocity distribution, we get ISM as the following, and A star is called Richardson constant. Since at zero bias there is no net flow of current, and ISM is balanced by IMS. So from this we get IMS also, and the total current we get I as a summation of ISM and I. And from that the IV curve we get is exponentially increasing with very low turn on voltage. Now what if phi m less than phi s? It will be a very good ohmic contact, and the same current flow in both the direction for forward bias and reverse bias. So IV curve will be linear. Properties and applications. Schottky diodes are used in many applications due to its low turn-in voltage and fast recovery time due to unipolar devices. It also has higher efficiency and low junction capacitance and low power consumption due to low turn-in voltage. It has fast switching because it's having only majority carriers and no storage time like PN junction diode. It is also used in high current low voltage circuit due to higher current drive capability. Also used in optical communication due to higher speed. Other applications are photodetector, solar cell. It is also used as a switch in fast clamp diode applications and in power rectifier applications due to higher current density and low forward voltage drop.
The Schottky barrier height at the semiconductor metal junction is the potential barrier that electrons in the metal encounter while attempting to migrate into the semiconductor. From the Venn diagram of Schottky diode, it is evident that the barrier height phi b is simply the difference between the metal work function phi m and the semiconductor electron affinity chi s. The Schottky barrier height at the semiconductor metal junction is the potential barrier that electrons in the metal encounter while attempting to migrate into the semiconductor. From the Venn diagram of Schottky diode, it is evident that the barrier height phi b is simply the difference between the metal work function phi m and the semiconductor electron affinity chi s. For the ideal case, we need to consider various assumptions that the metal to semiconductor contact is intimate and we have an ideal surface for semiconductor. Also, that we don't have metal to semiconductor interdiffusion. Considering these assumptions, we can approximate it using the Schottky Mott rule, according to which it's just the difference between the metal work function and semiconductor electron affinity, as we have seen before in the diagram. We have seen the formula before for current density. One thing to notice is that Schottky barrier height phi b appears in the exponential, and hence any minor change from ideal value will emerge in the current voltage equation in exponential amounts, and will have a significant impact on the current, which makes Schottky barrier height very important factor for Schottky diode. Let's discuss Schottky effect. We know from electrostatics that if there is a metal in the nearby region of a charge, the electric field at the metal surface will bend, resulting in all of the electric fields being perpendicular to the metal surface. We can solve for the exact electric field using the method of images, which assumes that we have an equal and opposite charge at the same distance from the interface. For Schottky diode, as carriers approach the metal semiconductor interface, the image charges build up in the metal electrode of a metal semiconductor junction, and because of the potential associated with this charge, the effective barrier height is actually reduced, which is conveyed from the graph. Let's discuss interface states. In reality, regardless of the work function values, charge interface states can pin the Fermi level at a given energy value, altering the barrier height for both carriers, a phenomenon known as Fermi level pinning. In contrast to the Schottky Mott rule, the barrier height generally exhibit minimal dependency on the value of semiconductor or metal work functions. Various semiconductors exhibit different degrees of Fermi level pinning. Next, barrier height inhomogeneity. In reality, the barrier height is not constant throughout the contact region. Changes in the interfacial layer composition produce these barrier height variations. We know that formula for reverse saturation current is given by this formula. Now if we take log on both sides, we get this equation, according to which if we plot ln Js by t squared versus q by kt, we should get a linear behavior. Let's see the plot for aluminium, indium, gallium, nitride. We can clearly see that we have large deviations in low temperature region, but for high temperature, we have linear relation where the ideality factor is close to 1. So we have discussed
various effects that lead to deviation from ideal behavior. Now let's discuss a simulation study that takes this into account and gives a model that explains the real Schottky diode. We see that classical theory only considers that barrier is constant, which leads to deviations. The non-linear T dependence of diode parameters, as we have seen before, is explained by a model of continuous Gaussian distribution of barrier heights. Here we are considering that a diode is given by several parallel diodes with varying barrier heights, each contributing to the current I in their independent way, and follows current given by equation for homogeneous Schottky diode by TED theory. The distribution of barrier height rho is considered to be Gaussian. We calculate the net current as given in the previous formulas. The plot shows Richardson plots that we have seen in the previous slide, but for various values for constant mean and standard deviations. Important to note that the plot for higher values of standard deviation clearly resembles the nonlinear plot as we have previously seen, which conveys that inhomogeneity leads to deviation from ideal behavior. Let's just summarize what we have learned. We have found that MOS-based Schottky structure provide better performance than metal semiconductor-based. We also explained the working of Schottky diode, which leads to various properties. Also, we discussed many applications and role in our lives. We have found that Schottky barrier height has a great impact on working of Schottky diode, and also many factors leads to deviation from ideal conditions, and also simulation are very helpful to study these systems. Here are our references. Thank you.